Going on, everybody. This month we're going to do a little bit of talking about picking up lumber, milling your own lumber, and doing some stuff like that. It's going to be a pretty brief overview. If we get some more interest in some things like this, I'm more than happy to go into a little bit more detail. So the first thing you got to do to mill your own lumber is finding a log to go pick up. I had these logs here. A guy contacted me on Facebook, actually. I got a Facebook page, and I'm starting to make a name for myself to the point where my friends and my family know that I do this kind of stuff. So I do get people out of the blue that contact me and want me to come pick logs up. I don't pay for any of the logs. I can just offer a service as far as hauling away some of the bigger trunks for free. So once you find a log, you're either going to pick it up and take it somewhere to mill it. I try and do that most often if I can, just kind of like having home field advantage. I've got all the tools I need. I have access to a shop and stuff like that if my saw breaks. The other option is going to be milling them at the house or wherever they lay out in the woods. That's just a little bit more tricky. You got some time constraints. It makes a lot of sawdust. People don't necessarily like you making a mess in their yard, so I always kind of go out of my way to clean up extra good, take yard bags, haul off sawdust, do all that kind of stuff if people are gracious enough to let me cut in their house or in their yard for a day or two. All this stuff is done with a Steel 088. It's the biggest saw that Steel makes. I think it's 127 cc's, and it runs a 404 skip tooth chain and a Granberg Alaskan mill. So that's my setup here.
All right, after all this work, after getting the log, putting it on the trailer, bringing it back here, getting it off the trailer, getting everything set up, chain sharpened, all that, this is where we're at. We made our first cut, and it's kind of like Christmas morning. You never know what's going to be inside the tree. You don't know if there's going to be bugs or rot or anything like that. There might be a little bit down at that end. I don't see anything at this end, but we're about to find out. Yeah. So there you go, beautiful cherry log.
All right, here you can see I've got a bunch of these logs stacked and what we call stickered. It allows for air to flow in between. They're just sitting out in the woods right now. They are drying. This is just air drying to get down to where they equalize with the relative humidity in the air. So once you get it stacked, then you're playing the waiting game. You got to wait for it to dry. Depending on the thickness of the wood, you got to wait to put it into a kiln, and then go from there. So that's kind of the short version of how I mill my lumber and my setup, and how I go about getting logs and things like that. Thanks.